are part and parcel of that distortion.
Yeah, I'm North Minneapolis.
The way human beings operate, if we are presented with some heat, them dynamic, Ed. That too much of the diversity sphere falls into. By wanting to seek out other viewpoints, by wanting to understand where the police were coming from, how they feel in moments of confrontation. said what she meant by selling the black community. And they said no, because they were so angry. I said, well, ask her. Start a conversation. Let's assume that you understood her point. Maybe she has a point, and you will often get her emotions and easy for you. Just start a conversation. To bust out of us against them. Yes, I know, they'll say, but we're the ones who are being otherized by the police. And you can ask them, how does payback amount to progress? And I think, Ed, this is the big opportunity we're missing right now in our cultural moment, is that us against them is often being opposed through tactics that screen us against them. So it's like two rival teams on a field, each of them wearing uniforms and then swapping out their uniforms. All they're doing is trading jerseys. One was called powerful, now it wears the jersey of the powerless. One was called powerless, now it wears the jersey of the powerful. All they're doing is trading uniforms. They're not changing the game. And I'm hoping through, the kind of work that I do, and that others are doing, make no mistake about that, that we can dissolve. And this made sense, a lot of sense, 50, 70,000 years ago, when our ancestors, hunter-gatherers, were out in the fields scavenging. Any rustle in the bush could have ended their lives. So no wonder evolution gifted us the ego. Its job is to keep us alive. Here's the problem. An ego is right once in a while, but most of the time, it's wrong. It confuses mere discomfort with mortal danger. So, if we're being disagreed with, for example, on something that we're passionate about, the ego senses your stress and it kicks into action and it signals to you that you are in a life and death situation. So get ready to fight, freeze, or control. Because the ego manipulates us into survived. You need to be aware of this tendency. It's addictive, and when we are validated, when our opinions are agreed with, we get a little burst of dopamine. So minuscule, we don't even realize it, but here's what we do know. We're not feeling any pain. And because we're not feeling any pain, we love the moment. And the more we crave it, the more we chase it. Again, utterly biological. So the question is, you know, do we have the willingness? We have the capacity. This much I can tell you. We have the willingness, more of us, to tame our egos in order to listen to where others are coming from. And I hope to explain just a little later on why it's worth the effort to listen to where others are coming from.
You're listening to Earshad Manji, speaking recently at a virtual event hosted by the St. Olaf.
And at that point, of course, you know, he launched into something about black on black crime. He actually, you know, didn't realize that this is also part of President Obama's legacy. And then,
black and white, now it's so different. it seems so right. Before I met you, everything was black and white, but it's so different. Now it seems so bright. You bring the color to my life. You bring the color.
This next generation, the one that's at university now,
you bring the color to my life.